We've had the loss of Eric the Midget on the Stern Show, who's a big fan. And I'll say this, here's my little eulogy of Eric. Not only did he convince his friends and his family not to use the term midget, but he went into the lion's den and fought that fight with the Howard Stern people. It's as though he went there to say, you should respect women more and you shouldn't have women naked on your show, and eventually convince people that that is correct. What he overcame in that arena is astounding. When he first said, I refuse to be called Eric the Midget and I will not be flown with balloons, and he started to negotiate his way out of that, I thought, I will never call him anything but Eric the Midget. But when he died, I found myself calling him Eric the Actor. Mm-hmm. He became Eric the Actor. He changed people's attitudes about the name and the use of that word. Mm-hmm. He became our friend that is a midget, that is a little person, that we couldn't use that word anymore. And so I really commend him. For all of his failings, he fought that fight in the hardest arena. He never backed down from it. And when he was done fighting that fight, he convinced and changed the minds of most of the people that listened.
That's why he was my favorite. He stood his ground in a lot of ways, whether it made sense or not, where most of the whackpackers will do anything, take a fish on the ass. He wouldn't do, if he didn't want to do it or he didn't want to play a role, he just wouldn't do it.
I do feel badly that I don't think he was able to appreciate his success. He was so embroiled in the battle. He never, rarely got his chance to pull his head up from the churning surf of those fights in order to get a fresh breath and enjoy his success or anything. He was always fighting, always under battle, and I don't think he got a chance to enjoy it much. But that's a lot of people.
I'm club fucking footed, you asswipe.